Students, let us discuss integration of dx upon root 3 sin x plus cos x. So these are important questions, okay? So whenever you have under root of 3 sin x plus cos x, you have to integrate here. These are in the formula, a form of a sin x plus b cos x. Whenever you have a sin x plus b cos x, that is, I can write under root of a square plus b square. We should use this one, under root of root 3 square plus 1 square, that is under root of 3 plus 1, that is root 4, root 4 value 2. That must be divided here. Integration of dx upon, I can write as root 3 by 2 sin x plus cos x by 2. You have to divide by 2. So what I am getting here, when I am dividing this, I have to multiply also. So 1 by 2 integration dx upon root 3 by 2 sin x plus cos x by 2. This root 3 by 2 is what is the answer? Cos 60 degrees? Sine 60 degrees? Yeah, sine 60 degrees. Sine 60 is root 3 by 2 and 1 by 2 is cos 60 degrees. So sine A, sine B, sine A. Sine A, sine B plus cos A, cos B. I repeat here. 1 by 2 integration of dx upon, you can write as sine 60 degrees into sine x plus cos 60 degrees into cos x. This is looking like as which formula? Cos A minus B formula. So I can write as 1 by 2 dx upon cos A minus B, that is x minus 60 degrees. 1 by 2, 1 upon cos, 1 upon cos is sec x minus 60 degrees. So what is the integration of sec x? Ln sec x plus tan x. So 1 by 2 ln mod sec x x minus pi by 3 plus tan x minus pi by 3 plus c. This is your answer. It should not divide anything because x coefficient is 1. Okay, understood. This is the answer. Let us go for another question. Integration of dx upon a sin x plus b cos x. So whenever you want to do integration of these type of questions, I just discussed this one and immediately I'm discussing this. So you know that a sin x plus b is cos x, always you have to write you have to take the under root of a square plus b square, that should be multiplied and divide. So I am multiplying this 1 by under root of a square plus b square, integration of dx upon, here dividing a by under root of a square plus b square, sin x plus b upon under root of a square plus b square cos x. So you know that a by under root of a square plus b square, I can consider some angle, that is sin alpha. B by under root of a square plus b square, I consider some angle, cos alpha. Okay, then alpha is equal to what? I can write as sine inverse this, or alpha is equal to cos inverse this. I can write anything, alpha value. So now what I am getting, 1 by under root of a square plus b square dx upon, this is just now I said sin x sin alpha plus cos alpha cos x, that is cos a minus b formula, cos x minus alpha formula. So 1 by under root of a square plus b square, this I can write as sec x minus alpha dx. So 1 by under root of a square b square, that can I write as, according to this formula, ln mod sec x minus alpha plus tan x minus alpha plus c. And now what I can write here, alpha I can change. tan inverse. So now I can write as alpha value, I can change. 1 by under root of a square plus b square ln mod sec x minus, what is alpha I said? Alpha is nothing but sine inverse a by under root of a square plus square. Otherwise, alpha is equal to cos inverse b by under root of a square plus b square. So what I can write as 1 by under root of a square b square ln mod sec x minus alpha plus, I can write sine inverse a by under root of a square plus b square tan x minus sine inverse a by under root of a square plus b square plus c. Sometimes option may appears in the form of cos also. So cos, if it is there, then I can write cos also. It may be in tan also, by division that it may be in tan also. But according to right now, this is the answer.